Good morning, my friends. It is very good to see you. We have here represented every single member of the International Coalition to Combat ISIL. Almost all of them represented at the ministerial level, defense minister level. And I'm very grateful for each and every one of you for taking the time to be here. Travel the distance that you do. It brings you so many friends around this table. And this is a time, this is a very important time for us to meet, and it's an important time to show our solidarity as friends. Thanks to this global coalition, our clear and deliberate military campaign plan, our dedicated global partner forces, and the sacrifices of our military members, we now have momentum in this fight, and we have clear results on the ground. And today, we'll make the plans and commitments that will help us deliver ISIL a lasting defeat, the defeat it deserves. We're going to destroy both the fact and the idea of an Islamic state based on ISIL's barbaric ideology. Our coalition's military campaign plan, as you all know, has three objectives. The first is to destroy ISIL's parent tumor in Iraq and Syria. That's necessary, but it's not sufficient. As recent attacks in our homeland remind us, ISIL's safe havens threaten not only the lives of the Iraqi and Syrian people, but also the security of our citizens in other countries. And the sooner we defeat ISIL in Iraq and Syria, the safer our countries will be. But we have a second objective also, which is to combat ISIL's metastases everywhere they emerge around the world. And we have a third and very important mission, which is to help protect our homeland along with enforcement and intelligence teams. Now, in January of this year, we all, those of us at this table, updated our comprehensive coalition military campaign plan to meet those three objectives. Our campaign strategic approach is to identify and enable capable and motivated local forces who can deliver ISIL a lasting defeat. Only local forces can deliver and sustain such a defeat by holding and governing territory after it has been retaken from ISIL. And we pursued a number of deliberate decisions and actions to accelerate this plan and hasten ISIL's defeat. This time last year, we put our coalition military campaign plan for Iraq and Syria under one single command, charging Lieutenant General Sean McFarland as the overall operational command. Then we introduced a series of initial accelerants to help us gather momentum. And of course, we asked all our coalition countries to make additional contributions to the campaign, and you did. As we did so, we also set in motion a series of specific and deliberate steps through the winter, the spring, and now in the summer. The first plays in the game, as President Obama called them, that we would accomplish as soon as possible to put ISIL on a path to a lasting defeat. And since then, play by play, town after town, from every direction and in every domain, our campaign has accelerated further, squeezing ISIL and rolling it back towards Raqqa and Mosul. We're isolating those two cities and effectively setting the stage to collapse ISIL's control over them. We see that on the ground in Iraq, as I saw firsthand last week during my most recent visit there. We're enabling the dedicated Iraqi security forces and the Peshmerga, led by Prime Minister Abadi and supported by Kurdish Regional President Barzani. And after clearing Ramadi and establishing a staging base in Lahore, the Iraqi security forces moved on to liberate Heat, Rooftop, and Fallujah. Then early last week, they seized the strategically important Diyar West airfield, which is a critical logistical springboard for the effort to collapse ISIL's control. And in Syria, we're also seeing results. After seizing Shaddadi, a crucial junction on the road between Mosul and Raqqa, our partners on the ground have now surrounded Manbij City, which is one of the last junctions connecting Raqqa to the outside world and a key transit point for external plotters threatening the homeland. We've also been pressuring ISIL by systematically eliminating their key leaders and their financial base, in addition to taking out key ISIL ministers and capturing one of the principals of ISIL's chemical warfare enterprise. We've killed over 20 of ISIL's external operators who were actively plotting to attack our homelands and our personnel. And wherever our local partners have moved, whether in Anbar, Nineveh, or Manbij, we've taken out ISIL's field commanders. Meanwhile, we're continuing attacks on ISIL's economic infrastructure, from oil wells and trucks to cash storage sites. And we're taking the fight to ISIL across all domains, including cyber. Thanks to the hard work and sacrifice of our local partners and our service members, and additional timely coalition contributions from those gathered here, we've seized opportunities, reinforced success, and taken the fight to the enemy. But we must not rest. We need to make the plans and the commitments to build on our momentum and deliver ISIL's lasting defeat. Today, we need to review and agree on the next plays in our campaign, which General Votel, who's doing an extraordinary job on this campaign, will walk us through on a map, and we'll discuss them in detail. And then we'll identify the capabilities and the support required to execute those next plays. Since February, our nations, including the United States, have provided even more support to accelerate the campaign as our local partners have made advances. In fact, 2/3 of our coalition members have pledged or already made additional military contributions since then, while many other members of nations have contributed vital economic, political, and humanitarian support. But we're all going to need to do more. Today, we'll identify both our enduring and emerging requirements and review our detailed matrix of national contributions, which you've seen before, going through it row by row, column by column, and country by country. We must ensure that our partners on the ground have what they need to win and fight, and then hold, rebuild, and govern their territory. This last point, we need to ensure that our economic and political campaign do not lag behind our military progress. It's critical and a significant strategic priority. We'll discuss it today and then again tomorrow at the State Department with our foreign minister, colleague. Of course, as I said earlier, destroying ISIL's counter-terror in Iraq and Syria is necessary, but it's not sufficient. ISIL's influence and activities continue to pose a threat in Afghanistan, where I was last week, as well as Libya and elsewhere. Today, we'll also discuss how we can continue to combat ISIL wherever it might attempt to take hold, and how our military campaign can best support our national government's efforts to protect our respective homeland and our people. That's a full agenda. And this is a critical moment. Today is an important opportunity to build on our momentum and deliver ISIL a lasting defeat. Before we begin our discussions, let me ask my friend and colleague, French Minister of Defense Jean-Yves Le Drian, to make a few opening comments as well. Jean-Yves, you have been a great leader, a critical partner, a strong leader, a staunch ally in this fight. I want to offer again my condolences to the French people and to the French government for your nation's losses in last week's attack in Nice. Our total solidarity with the French people and our admiration for your strong personal leadership. The floor is yours, John. Thank you.
Merci, H, et merci de ce message de soutien qui est partagé par nos collègues à un moment où mon pays traverse une épreuve supplémentaire.
Thank you, H, and thank you for your message of support, which is shared by all our colleagues at the time in our country is going through a time of difficult time.
L'État islamique recule aujourd'hui partout. Et la France a longtemps appelé à une intensification de notre action collective contre ce groupe barbare, car nous sommes intimement persuadés que notre intérêt de sécurité en France, en Europe, mais aussi aux États-Unis et au Moyen-Orient, est de détruire les bases territoriales de l'État islamique. Car ce sont ces bases qui lui permettent d'organiser et de planifier des attaques contre nos ressortissants, de lancer des mots d'ordre généraux pour que des petits groupes isolés, voire des individus, agissent et mettent en péril les fondements même de notre vie ensemble. On l'a vu, hélas, à Nice, en France, le 14 juillet. Mais on l'a vu aussi en Allemagne, on l'a vu aussi ailleurs. Il faut vaincre l'ennemi au cœur pour en enrayer les métastases. Vous l'avez dit, Daesh a connu des repères importants sur le terrain, que ce soit Fallujah, Kaïra, combat actuel à Mandij. La phase dans laquelle nous entrons est cruciale, est décisive, et nous avons une opportunité en restant unis et en affectant suffisamment de moyens de priver Daesh de ses bases arrières, de les isoler suffisamment pour en réduire l'intérêt dans la planification d'attentats ou la diffusion de sa propagande. Et la France jouera toute sa part dans la période qui s'ouvre. Et nous sommes
conscient également, et H en a parlé, et ce sera l'objet de nos discussions, que le combat ne s'arrête pas à l'Irak et à la Syrie. Nos services de renseignement et de sécurité publique devront rester mobilisés pendant des années. Nous devons trouver le moyen de lutter ensemble contre la diffusion des idées radicales et violentes qui pervertissent les esprits. Et nous devons aussi en même temps trouver les voies d'une stabilisation politique des territoires sur lesquels Daesh prospère, qu'il s'agisse de la Syrie, de l'Irak, de la Libye. Nous devons aussi parallèlement aider les pays les plus démunis qui sont en première ligne, comme ceux du pourtour du lac Tchad. Pour conclure ces propos, je voudrais remercier tout spécialement Ashton Carter pour son leadership. Je sais que nous lui devons beaucoup dans la structuration d'une stratégie globale et cohérente contre Daesh. Je remercie d'avoir accepté que nous puissions régulièrement nous rencontrer dans ce format, parce que c'est dans ce format que l'on assure la détermination de tous et l'unité dans notre combat. Et merci tout particulièrement H d'avoir été très proche de la France dans les heures difficiles que nous venons de traverser depuis 2015.
ISIL is being pushed back today everywhere. France has for a long time called for an intensification of our collective action against this barbaric group, because we have been intimately convinced for months that our interest in terms of security in France and in Europe, but also in the United States and in the Middle East, is to destroy the territorial basis of ISIL. These make it possible for ISIL to organize and plan attacks against our citizens, to launch general instructions that little isolated groups or even individuals will apply, as we have seen recently in France, in Nice on the 14th of July, and this Monday in Germany and elsewhere, in other places as well. Daesh has registered major defeats on the ground in Ramadi, Hit, Fallujah, Qaira, and Manbij. The phase in which we are now entering is crucial because it gives us an opportunity, by remaining united and by providing enough resources for this fight, to deprive ISIL of its real basis and to isolate it enough to reduce the interest of planning terrorist attacks or distributing its propaganda. We are, however, conscious, and this will be the subject of our discussion here today, that the fight will not stop at Iraq and Syria. Our intelligence services and public safety must remain mobilized for years, and we have to find ways to fight together against the diffusion of these radical violent ideas, which are perverted spirits. We have to find ways to stabilize politically territories on which ISIL is prospering, in Libya or in Syria. We have also to help the most destitute countries, which are in the first line of the fight, including those around Black Lake Chad. As a conclusion, I would like to thank most particularly, again, Ashton Carter for his extraordinary leadership. I know that we owe a lot to him for structuring this global and coherent strategy against ISIL, for having accepted that we could meet regularly in this format to make sure that the determination of all and that we are united in this fight. I'm saying this here, he has been a good friend of France in the difficult hours that my country has known since January 2015. Thank you.
Thank you all very much.